Hey everybody, it's Chris Eads, known on the line as Wootini, here with another Gay Gamer video podcast. I really got my money's worth out of my AMC A-list subscription this past week. As you know, last weekend I went to see Close. Then I had a couple days off work for vacation, and on Tuesday I went to see the 25th anniversary re-release of Titanic in IMAX 3D. And aside from some of the little CGI people walking along the decks of the ship looking a little dodgy on a big IMAX screen, it holds up pretty well. And it's a good 3D conversion, even though it wasn't shot for 3D. It still looks nice in 3D. It just brings you into the world and all. And it's, you know, it's Titanic. It is what it is. It's super cheesy, but thoroughly entertaining. And there you go. And then the following day, I went to see The Wandering Earth 2, which it turns out is actually a prequel to The Wandering Earth, which I did not know. So on the train into the city to go to the theater, I'm like reading the Wikipedia page for The Wandering Earth because we saw it like, you know, a couple years ago. And just to brush up on the plot. And then I get there and it starts out and I'm like, oh, it's a prequel. Never mind. There's like one character who's in both movies. So it's a crazy science fiction movie. I sort of like the first one better because the first one is like super futuristic and crazy. This one is set on like, you know, sort of near future present day Earth. And it's the beginning of the Wandering Earth program where the sun is going to like supernova or whatever. So we have to like get Earth, save humanity by getting Earth out of the way of the sun. And to do that, they propose to build engines along the side of the planet to propel the entire planet like a spaceship through space. But first we have to get rid of the moon, which causes a whole hours long worth of problem because it's a 3-hour movie. It's very epic. And it's thoroughly entertaining. It's got some great action set pieces and crazy science fiction shenanigans, like moving the planet. Although honestly, to me, the most ridiculous and implausible aspect of this entire film series is that all of the world's governments would put aside their differences and come together to save the entire planet as a whole. Because, dude, if that ever needs to happen, like, Earth is doomed. We are fucked beyond reason. The propaganda is not subtle. China comes up with this plan, and the world says, okay, we'll go along with it. I mean, after a bunch of nonsense happens and whatever, and then there's arguments and stuff, but China saves the world, basically. And it's a whole, like, multicultural cast. There's, like, French and Russian and English and Chinese and everything. And what's hilarious is that the American people are awful. Like, the actors are so bad. It has to be on purpose. Although I don't know if it's the actors or the people doing the voice, because sometimes the voices don't seem to match the actor saying them. So I don't know if they like had an actor and then decided, no, his performance is too good. Let's dub in somebody who can't really act. Because they just, it has to be on purpose that like all of the American actors are terrible. And it's hilariously distracting. But then at the end, when it's supposed to be like the countdown and oh my God, we might not be able to save the planet and oh no, like it totally diffuses the tension because the American guy is yelling about how you've blown it and we're all going to die, except the voice actor is so bad that it's like ruining the end of the climax of the movie and all. So I'm like, ugh, but it's still fun. And I wanted to see this one on the big screen because watching the first one on Netflix was like, you know, okay, but I was like, this is a big science fiction epic thing and needs to be a spectacle on the big screen. So and it finally, because it was super crowded for like weeks, and finally it wasn't crowded, so I was able to go, and there were like hardly anybody in the theater, so I was able to enjoy my popcorn and soda. I felt comfortable taking my mask off for a bit to have my birthday popcorn and soda because it's free with AMC. So and then of course this weekend I went to see Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania, which I know people are ragging on this one, like, a lot, but I enjoyed it, surprisingly. I saw it in IMAX 3D. It has some good 3D here and there. It's not, like, super made for 3D, but it was thoroughly entertaining, and there was good 3D and stuff. It's fun. Like, it's weird because it's, like, it gets a little more serious than the previous Ant-Man movies, but I liked this one better than the second one because this one has, like, a plot. And I really liked the Quantum Realm. Like, visually, I thought it was really cool looking, and I loved all the weird characters. Some are human, some are certainly not. And Jonathan Majors is super creepy and very chilling. He's a very good villain. Kang is, props to him. And so I am looking forward to seeing more of him, because I know this is to set up Kang as the big bad for, like, future Avenger movies and stuff. But to my surprise, I was afraid this was going to end with, like, practically end with a cliffhanger. It doesn't. It feels very, it has a satisfying ending. So I was like, okay, good. I mean, obviously the two end credits tags lead you into the next phase, but, it still feels like a self-contained, okay, here is a beginning, a middle, and an end. And I like that it just jumps right in. It's all adventure. It's all crazy insanity. And then it ends. And you're like, yay. So it never drags. There's no dull moments. And I liked it better than the second one. Oh, there is another villain who I kind of wish I didn't know was in it. Supporting character. Because it would have been really funny. I would have loved to have just not known about it and have him show up on screen and go, oh my god. So I won't mention who it is, but I do feel like some people might complain that, oh, well, they changed the, you know, it's not the actual character from the comic because they changed his origin to fit him in with the Ant-Man movies. And I'm like, it's fine. I thought it was fine just to see him again, except for the fact that the special effect that they use on him is really, 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 really bad. Everything else I thought was great. I know people are complaining about the effects. I had no problem with the effects, except for that one character. The effect they used to create this character is terrible, and it's the kind of thing where they should have said, okay, here, and the director should have said, no, go back and fix that, because that looks super cheap and horrible. Make it better. What are you going to do? And then after I film this and upload it, this afternoon, I am going back to the movies to see Avatar: The Way of Water again, because it's no longer in IMAX 3D, but it's Prime 3D. But I wanted to go back and see it again in 3D because I don't trust that this one is going to get a 3D Blu-ray home release. Maybe James Cameron can force them to do it. I don't know. But I want to see it again the way it's meant to be seen in 3D before it goes away and it's just on TV. As for games, I did download the Game Boy app for the Nintendo Switch. Like I said, I'm not getting the other one to get the Game Boy Advance games and everything. All I've played so far was I played a round of Tetris, and oof, I was not very good at it. It's been a while since I played Tetris, so I was not very good. I did really good for like the first like couple of minutes, and then it was like. but I wanted to see what they had in there, and I'm very curious about Alone in the Dark, but I don't know, I don't want to play that, because I need things that I can just, like, jump in and out of, like Tetris, or Dr. Mario, or play a couple of Picross puzzles. Something like Alone in the Dark, I need to be able to play that, and then just play it through. I don't want to, play it, and then take some time off, and then try to go back and remember where I left off. That's why I haven't played any of the RPGs, like the SNES library, they've got like Breath of Fire and stuff, and I'm like, oh, I would totally play that, except that I need to choose to play that game straight through. You know, I can't play it and then like go play something else for a couple of weeks and then go back to it, because I'll forget where I was. So it's something I need to say, like, okay, after Fallout 4, I'll play Alone in the Dark, or Breath of Fire, or whatever. Because I am still playing Fallout 4, much to my surprise. Yes, the world is still grim, and everything is destroyed, and it's not a fun world to explore, but I'm still okay with it. I feel like it takes a little while before it just weighs on me, and then I just am like, I don't want to go back to that world. I'd like to go someplace prettier. Because it is pretty grim, and everything is destroyed. Like, I went to Diamond City, as you might recall at the end of last episode, I was on the verge of entering Diamond City. Well, after I taped last week's episode, I went into Diamond City. And I don't know what I was expecting, but I was not expecting, like, another shanty town full of little tents and shacks and whatever. And it just still looks decrepit. It's just protected inside Fenway Park. The only place that looks like pre-war is that town I found where they were all afraid of synths. I want to say Covenant, maybe? That, behind their brick walls, they've got like a few houses and a garden, and like the houses are all relatively like solid, and they have walls and roofs and everything, and they look mostly normal. Everything else is just ruins, and it's kind of sad. But I did do the main quest to try to find Nick Valentine, which of course you don't just find Nick Valentine. He's not there, he's been kidnapped, and you have to go rescue him, which turned into a whole thing that took days and days to do. But I did finally rescue him, and I was very surprised to find out that Nick Valentine, spoiler alert for a 15-year-old game, he's a synth. So maybe synths aren't so bad. Maybe it's only the ones that are, like, secretly replacing humans and doing bad things. They're the bad ones. So it's like people. Some are good, some are bad. And then he's like, come and see me in Diamond City, and we'll look for your son. And I'm like, cool. I'm just going to go do a couple of other things before I go back there. And then I totally got distracted doing random things, like finding a hospital. I'm like, let me just explore the hospital, get some medical stuff. And that was fine, killing like feral ghouls, because I had found a comic book store where I got this axe, the barbarian's axe, the comic book character. But it's an actual axe, and it does really good damage. And it's got like special features and bonus features and stuff. So like I'm like hacking away at the feral ghouls with my axe, and it's great fun. I get to the bottom of the hospital, and it turns out that, that was the one with the death claw or whatever it is that, like, I was like, rah! And I'm, like, trying to shoot it, and I was, like, barely making any dent in his health, and then he kills me. And I was like, you know what, we'll come back to this later when I have better weapons. Bye. Because there was another place, I decided I was going to try to follow the Freedom Trail to look for the railroad. And I started following that, which you discover buildings and stuff. And one of them, I was like, oh, this is fine. It's just raiders. This is fine. And then I get to the bottom, and then it's like, oh, no, it's a giant Mirelurk, which I managed to kill. But then when I restored the power to get the door open so I could leave, then there was a queen Mirelurk that was even bigger. And I was like, and she killed me right away. So that was bad. So I was like, I'll come back here when I've got a better weapon. But then I got all distracted again because, I come out of the building and I'm like, oh, what's over here? Oh, what's over here? And I don't follow the quest line properly. And I found this building and there was all these raiders and I go into Pikmin's house. Pikmin is a, H.P. Lovecraft reference, which I now know having watched a couple of TV shows recently that told the story of Pikmin, not well. So I'm killing all these raiders. I get down into this tunnel system in the sewers, and it's this epic, epic trail that I'm following, and things are super creepy. There's, like, creepy artwork, and there's, like, dead bodies used to make sculptures, and it's really, really, really creepy. I kill all of these raiders, and then I meet Pikmin, and he's all like, hey, thanks for killing all those raiders for me. Here's a key to my safe and my goodies, and you can have whatever treasure you like. Thanks so much. And I was like, you are welcome. And then I'm like, you are a serial killer, but you also kill raiders, which is kind of a public service, really. So I didn't kill him. I let the serial killer live, even though he's clearly insane, because he's killing raiders. I only have evidence that he's killing raiders. So I'm like, you know what? I'll let you live. You're okay by me. So, and then I got annoyed because as I was wrapping that up, I haven't actually gone to open his safe yet because I left his house and I have to go back in to open up the safe and get my reward. But I got this notification that Sanctuary was under attack. So I had to like fast travel back to Sanctuary where there were a few raiders coming in. And they mostly were able to take care of themselves. I think I killed one raider and helped kill another. That was it. So I'm like, okay. But that's kind of annoying. And I'm like, oh, this could get irritating. And that's why I'm like, I don't want to make settlements all over the place because then they'll get attacked. And then I've got to constantly be going and dealing with that, which is on top of all the other things that I've got going on, plus the main quest that I never get to because there's so much else to do. So still playing, still relatively enjoying it. Come back next episode and see if I still am. Bye!